Hare Krishna. Use your intelligence to identify and rectify your weaknesses, not to justify them. All of us have an intelligence, small or big, and we need to use it constructively. And the Bhagavad Gita explains that intelligence is a resource. Just like sometimes if there is a security person. Now that security person may be hired by a law-abiding citizen, by an important social leader to protect them. Or that same security person might be hired by a criminal to protect them. And now the security person should be used to protect the law abider, the law upholder, not the law breaker. So while these two citizens are separate, we can say within us are two sides. There is the spiritual side and the materialistic side. And our intelligence can be pulled by both. Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita points to this duality when he says that first in 3.40, he states that Indriyani mano buddhir asyadhishthanam uchyate etair vimohayatesha jnanamavritya dehinam. He says the self-destructive desire, kama, is present within us, within our senses, our mind and our intelligence. So our intelligence, when it is captivated by, say, lust, then we use our intelligence to justify our wrong-headed activities. We justify our conditioning, justify our weaknesses. We use our condition, we stay weak. That means when, if somebody is lusty, somebody is greedy, somebody is angry, they use their intelligence to say, this is how everyone is. What's wrong with this? This is just normal human nature. Or we may try to cover it up and pretend that it is not there at all. And justify to the world, or sometimes justify to ourselves. Say, nothing is very big, very seriously wrong. Everything is all right. Everything will become all right. So if we justify, then we keep ourselves trapped. It is, we need to identify and rectify it. Krishna points to this function of the intelligence three verses later in 3.43 when he says, evam buddhe param buddhva samsthabhyatmanam atmana jahi shatrum mahabaho kamarupam durasadam. Is evam buddhe. In this way, with using your intelligence, param buddhva, understand that you are transcendental. And samsthabhya atmanam atmana, situate yourself in the spiritual platform. And in this way, jahi shatrum mahabaho, conquer over this formidable enemy known as lust. Kamarupam durasadam. So Krishna is telling us that we need to use our intelligence to combat lust. How do we combat? First of all, because it's inside us, we need to identify it. So identify whenever a particular self-destructive desire comes up. Whenever any desire prompts us to act in an adharmic way, to act in an immoral way, and act in an anti-spiritual way, then we identify. This is my weakness. This is my conditioning. I need to resist it. And then how do we rectify it? By situating ourselves on the spiritual platform, by practicing bhakti and filling our consciousness with Krishna. When our consciousness thus becomes absorbed in Krishna, then we can rectify our conditionings. We'll become purified of those conditionings. So we need to use our intelligence not to justify, oh, I'm like this and I'll stay like this, but to identify the part of us, identify the conditioning and to rectify it. Thank you. Hare Krishna.